Alright guys, a little bit of bonus video here. I'm out here at Spring Valley Golf Club, 10th hole, par 3, 134 meters, 150 yards to the pin. Beautiful hole, kind of reminds me of Sawgrass in a way, except just with bunkers. There's no penalty if you miss the green, unless you are short-sighted. It's deadly. But it's a very fun hole to play. I love it, especially it's right next to the putting green and chipping green, so it's kind of a hole I can just come out and play after I've done my practice. And I also love it here because there's no one out here at this time. And being in Australia during this time of the year is just great because there's no wind at the moment. It gets very windy at times, like 30 miles an hour. Yesterday it was about 30 miles an hour. But it's beautiful at the moment. I'm gonna hit a nice little knockdown 9-iron for the draw. It's 150, 149 to be exact, but you know, 150. I'm gonna hit a couple shots from here and then a couple shots when my dad's gonna go up to the green so you guys can see how the ball reacts on the green. So let's hit these two. And right into the sun. Now the greens have just been sanded, so they're not very good at the moment, but they can change really fast. You can probably see the sand splatter as that ball hit the green. So I'm just gonna hit this one, and then my dad's gonna go up and I'm gonna hit a couple more. Don't tell anybody.
Looks like a bunker shot.
That's not the place to be. Left trap. Short-sided miss. So I'm gonna hit two more. My dad's gonna go up to the green so you guys can hopefully see how the ball reacts, but unable to see how the ball reacts. It has to hit the green. So hopefully I can do that.
All right, the fossil's walking down to the green here. Guys, I can't begin to tell you how gorgeous it is here at this time of day when there's not much wind. It's a beautiful golf course. It's stuck right in the middle of where all the sandbelt, all of Melbourne's famous sandbelt courses are. We're just underrated because it's relatively new. It's only 20 or 30 years old, whereas the sandbelt courses have been around since the dawn of time. So this is one of our lorikeets that we have in Australia. They're a parrot, beautiful bird. Check out the beautiful red. Check out the beautiful colouring on this guy. Is that a pretty bird or what? Oh, there they go. Alright, so let's see if we can get these two on the green. I don't know how Carl feels about it. I should really ask him, but when I played, I could never hit a ball when I was facing directly into the sun. This shot's got really nice shape on it. Yeah, straight at the pin, just 15 feet short. Really good little baby draw. It's good filming at this time of night too, because the subject lights up well. So that little baby draw is Carl's go-to shape. This shot looks good too. Not drawing in as much, but both are under the hole. So three of the four on the green. Putting for birdie on three of them. One of them's in the pot. Sounds easy, like normal, huh? Normally 150 yards, you just gobble it up. But this green's down below the tee and it's totally exposed. There's no trees protecting it near the green. So any little puff of wind does affect it, and you would have seen the flag moving just as Carl was hitting the ball there, so he wouldn't have felt that up on the green. But that's the 18th hole that we're looking at here. It's a clubhouse in the background. Fantastic club, really good practice facilities. And Carl's, it's tough. Isn't life tough when you're 14? It's too hard to walk down with your bag. You just leave your bag up there, and I think he's just in a hurry to get back and have the lamb that I'm roasting in the oven. God, we miss lamb when we're over in the US. Over the US, lamb's about the same price as caviar. Here, it's our standard meat that every family has at least a couple times a week. So nothing beats the taste of lamb, guys, but I digress. We're here to watch Carl play golf.
So I've been playing this shot a lot lately, just being in bunkers. Short-sighted myself, not the greatest, but it's pretty soft sand, so I'm hoping to get it close. I hit the green 3 out of 4 times, so I'm obviously 4 out of 4 would have been great, but also not the greatest slide to get it up and nice and high, but I'll try my best.
Ooh, nearly hit it.
That's about the best I could have done. I'm pretty sure I landed that on the fringe. Not quite sure. But under the hole was better because long, it's very fast down the hill. So a little shorter was my miss. Off the tee. Probably can't tell from looking at it, but the greens have been sanded a couple days ago, but it's rained, and they actually look pretty nice, but the practice putting green is still pretty bad. It actually recovered pretty quickly. I'm impressed. Now that wasn't a very good example, but one thing that's really improved since I've been at Spring Valley is my putting. I've spent a lot of time and dedicated a lot of time to the putts inside of 10 feet. These putts, there wasn't really much wrong with my technique. It was more, or my stroke, I should say. It was more the tilt back in my ribs were kind of just at impact, kind of just moving backwards. But other than that, I fixed it. I feel a lot more confident around the greens and on the greens. They're very slow, about the same speed actually as the chipping green, and that is pretty slow. I want to putt, hopefully these putts are, I get the speed right, because that would just be really bad if I didn't get these to the hole. Even if they were extremely slow, I should still be getting putts from this distance to the hole. I saw it go past the hole, so I think it's about just outside right edge and firm. Wasn't really firm. Really slow up the hill. Really slow. So this one's going to be downhill. Left to right. I'd really like to see myself make a birdie on this hole. out of the four balls. That'll be nice. Probably about 7 feet, 8 feet. That was actually pretty quick as it was down the hill. For some reason, it was actually very fast. Wasn't expecting that. But happy with four paws. I'll take that any day. Just very happy to get up and down from this bunker to that pin, because that was deadly. And vice versa, if it was from those bunkers. Just anywhere in these bunkers is deadly because they're so high, so soft. So with longer bunker shots, it's actually a little tougher because they're so soft. So it's very hard to, you know, make the right contact. It's very easy to misjudge where you're hitting the ball. But it was just a little bit of bonus video. I was hoping to make a birdie, but I didn't. A little disappointed, but whatever. Working on my game still, work in progress, going through a couple swing changes. Please don't ask what they are. But hopefully those are down pat by the time I play my next tournament, which is 5th of March. It's 2 days. It's a big tournament in the state, but it's got a lot of good players playing in it, and hopefully I can put a good result in there. And get my ranking up. Right now it's like 2,600, but that's a lot better than last year. But again, hopefully you enjoyed the video. I know I had a lot of fun just playing this hole. It's always fun to play any hole in the course except for the first hole. I hate it. I just don't like it. But every other hole is fun to play, and it's just such a great course, especially for juniors. They're very junior friendly, and it's got amazing practice facilities. The range that they have over here that for like the members before you go out and play is in the range I go to the one that's over there. It's like probably 340 yards long, so you can hit drivers, and the grass is amazing, probably like the fairways on the golf course. And the putting green, very nice. One side of the green is like kind of flat, and the other side is just so many slopes. And when they can get the greens running 14. A couple weeks ago, they were running 14 and a half for a tournament they had here. Now that's just for a tournament that was a club tournament. So it's very good. They respect everyone at the golf club. They want the course being as best as possible for all the members. The chipping area is, I've done a lot of videos there. Hopefully you were able to get some insight on how good that is. They have two chipping areas. But again, I'm gonna stop rambling on about how good my golf club. But hopefully you enjoyed the video, and see you guys soon.